بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
What is happening? What you're using Islam for? What? Islam is to unite, bring love. But Islam is hatred, divisions. This is what is dividing people into different sects. And this is unity. So can you see the difference now? Are you able to be present to the rational mind? Mind is to find solutions. That's all. Nothing else. Mind, bhogya, acceptance. So now this way is good, is nothing but the angelic nafs, is submission. This is submission. This is the denial. The moment I deny the truth, the reality, what happens? I connect to evil. This is it. This is how it is. This is how my house is. This is how my wife is. My husband is. This is how my financial situation is. This is how I am. This is it. This is it what? This is the way it is. That is called submission. Accepting the way this world is. Accepting the people as it is. They should be like this. They should not be like this. Should and should not be like this is what? Can you see this? No, this is it. So, I am not here to change people. We are not here to change people. We are here to make a difference to people. Is it not? To help people to see and remove people from darkness to light. This is the darkness. This is the blind. This is ignorance. This is jahiliya. To bring them into the light. And get this very clearly. You can't change anything without acknowledgement. Acknowledge. The moment you acknowledge, what you don't acknowledge, you can't change. This is the law. So first thing is what? Acknowledge. Acknowledge what? I am in the prison. Reality is what? I am in the prison. Acknowledge that I am in the prison. If I acknowledge I am not in the prison, then the question of coming out arises or no? Does it arise or no? When I don't acknowledge I'm not in the prison, bahar aane ka sawal hi nahi hai. There is no action. First, to come out of the prison is to acknowledge I am in the prison. This is what Allah is saying, is I'm in the prison. Means all mankind is at a loss. Pure insan kasare mein hai. I am at a loss. That is, first acknowledge I am at a loss. Not live like I am the saint, you are the villain. No, 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 no. I am the jerk, you are the saint to live with me. I am the loss, not they are the loss. When I am at the loss, then the question arises how to come out. Acknowledge first. So anything is acknowledge yourself. Whatever situation you are, you lost the job, you lost the job. 16 years I am married, there are no children, no children. I am not. I am divorced, I am divorced. I failed, I failed. I got diabetes, I got diabetes. I got cancer, I got cancer. Just acknowledge the reality. This is it. Reality has no meaning. So acceptance of reality, submission is of reality. Very clear? This is the submission way is what? Angelic nafs is what? Angel. Vasamiyana vatana. Hogya hogya. Now, next comes, it does not mean keeping quiet. Now what is possible? Now you are under this one. Now you are using the mind and the senses to find solution. Now that external body and the mind is a tool. Now this is where I want to achieve this. Now you are using your body and the senses to achieve your goal, destination. And your whole mind is to find solutions. Here, what are you looking for? Solutions. Here, what are you looking for? To make other person wrong. How to insult him? How to hang him? How to do him? I will show him. I will show maybe kon karke. All thinking of what? Here is what? Okay, oh yeah, this is what happened. Now what's possible? This has happened. Happened. Very clear? So this is the reality. Now, truth. Is it whatever I'm saying, is it truth or false? Based on what? Assumptions. Assumption. Assumption. This is what assumption. That is called illusion. This is called maya. This is whole thing. This is submission. Is it good or evil? This is the distinction. So now I have three tools with me. the realization faculty, and this one, and this three things. So now tell me now. How do I? You are talking. It's philosophy. It has become philosophy. It has become something only ideal. It's not possible to live. But it is in the battlefield. Prophet, 23 years the Prophet lived in the life, in the battle, in there, everyone, they lived everywhere. What is the way? I become the eye which you see. I become the ears which you hear. I become the mouth which you speak. And I become the hand which you hold. So now today, as Muslims, basic, one of the fundamentals of Islam is equality. Equality. Equality is what? Equality is seeing and treating every human being as human being. You as I as a human being, you want to be successful, you want to live for eternal, are you going to follow, we as human beings I created you, see and treat everybody human beings? This is the message, this is Islam, this is the basic, nothing else. Other thing is devotion to Allah is ibadah, is me and my Allah. Now Ramzan, Roza, these are all is my cleansing, purification, with this thing. But when I'm outside, that is Islam. That's what action. Iman, God, I believe. Then my saleh actions. Actions mean my day to day life. Make what is my action? Am I cheating? Am I behaving? What am I doing? So what is Islam? This is where I question myself. What is Islam really? I have to question. What is Islam? Very clear, previous. Now, another simple example I'll give you now. Let's deal with something. Now, when you start going to the masjid to pray, suddenly someone's mobile starts ringing. A response, now every moment, I listen to the khutbah. Now, what will happen? Come on, tell me now, inside. Come on, now tell me now, what will happen? Now, what will happen? Where? Abhi namaz mein khade andar kya ho raha tumhara? No, distraction is not that. You get distracted because of what? That is what you're saying, distraction. No. What has happened now? Moment there was someone ringing, what will happen now? You get connected to the rational mind or to the heart, sir. Come on. What does the rational mind say now? Andar kya bol raha hai man? Huh? Now you deny. Now this is a denier. This is a submitter. Now you deny the reality. What is the reality? What is the reality? Deny that. Are you going to submit that it is ringing? It is ringing, or it should not ring? It should ring or should not ring? Come on, tell me. As per you, it should ring or should not ring? Should not. The moment you said should not, you went to this one. Then what happened? What you did do? The moment you deny, you got connected here, then what happens to you now inside? Irritation came because of the mobile, the reality. The mobile is ringing, or is because for you it should not ring? Get this very clear now. This is very, very catchy. It is the reality is causing you the irritation, anger, or it is for you denying that it should not ring is causing you. Tell me. Denial, for you it is, should not ring. The moment you say should not ring, you got connected, then what happens now? Are you focusing on the salah or you gone away? Now this man said distraction. You got distracted not because of the mobile, because for you it should not ring, and then you go into the you're gone away. It is ringing, it is ringing. So I acknowledge it is ringing. It is ringing, it does not distract me. Because it's I have the power to focus my attention to what I want. That is what you have to develop. This mind under your control, where you want to fix, you can fix it. Kitna zor se TV loud kar dalo, I'm praying. The sound is coming because I'm focused there, I'm there, I'm there. The moment I said, you said TV dalenga to hi tak ke man, I went away. I say and go away. Next person go down. Are you getting very clear? So now how is the reaction? How do body reacting? Are you using this? Are you using this? Your husband 65 years goes and marries 25 year old girl and come. What happens now? Come and respond. See, this is what all happening. I'm not saying it will happen. I'm giving some extreme cases. External worlds are happenings. Now, which faculty am I using? Suddenly he gets and married second wife and brings her. They don't inform. And the woman, she comes to know what she, what her, what is the way she's using. She loses her sense and she, apne bachon ko, okay, what have you done? Have you chosen? Response is, I have the power to respond to what is happening. Who has to choose the response? When you are conscious, you will choose the response. That is your animal and react you. I got the power, whatever may happen in the external, I am responsible for my response. And if I don't have control over my response, we are reacting. We are not the Muslim, we are not, forget about human beings. Muslim meaning kya bhi nahi hai, only animals. So I chose the response. Now I said, okay, reality is, he married second wife and came, now what's possible? What is possible? Now solution, that means, what is possible is using the mind, now you are using possible. What's possible? One, I can stay with him, accept it. One, I don't want to deny, I can go away. I can ask talak, I can walk away. I can take this. I don't like it, I don't want to stay. You want to stay, you got married, there's your problem. I want to leave. Make justice, I want to go away. I want 1, 2, 3 options. But how do we deal with asking anything wrong? You marry, I have no power. But I want justice. I don't like it or I like it. Let's do this. Let's settle what's happening. This is a reality. That deny kar rahe. I say cases. Pure ke pure cases hamare pure quota mein hain. Because of what? Tell me. All our relationships, our properties, our everything, brother, businesses, partnership, everything is where? Marriages, divorces, where are they? So things are happening. Amanu saliha. Amanu means, are you responding to the situation? Are you using the shaitanic way or the animal way? Or are you choosing a response? Situations may come, worse situations may come. See the Prophet's life, my situations, kitne situations may have. He reacts. What happened? You, kya aa gaye the? Ashraf fekti thi. And then, masjid mein baithe, aake pishab kar diya. What happened? Ghar chhodna chota hai, phaka padna padha hai, bhagna padha. So which is the way of life the Prophet demonstrated us? And today what are we doing? That's why Shaitan said, I will take revenge. I will not leave you. I'll blame, complain. Revenge. That's what we are doing. Each one is standing for revenge. Pure ke pure vikitam gir rahe. Pure ke pure. Ek government, dusri government, dusri country, pure tootne ko. We are not standing for justice. Islam is justice. So now, you are going to walk out now. Are you going to live Islam or know Islam? Today is only about knowing Islam. You know, kya bolte hain? Devotion, I am not against devotion. Devotion, raabdin padlo, namaza padlo, khutba karo tumhe. That is my personal with God. Is it not? But how am I living my life and responding to everybody at home? Meri manmani, my way is the highway. Then where is Islam? Living Islam is, you will fall. This is part of your life. Not that you cannot judge and all that. You will judge. And opinion, judgment, this is my judgment. This is my opinion. Mere opinion. Is it not? About you, about this. This is my opinion, my judgment. Keep opinion, judgment as opinion, judgment there only. Not make it as a problem arises when I believe my opinion, judgment to be true. And then only I get blocked out. Not that I should not judge. My experience hai, mera opinion hai, mera judgment. Kisi ke baare mein poocha to inke baare mein kya hai? I'll give my opinion. My experience with this man is this. That's only my experience with that particular area only. It's not absolute. I don't know the other remaining things about it. I may say good. The other fellow might have experience bad about it. It's not bad. Nahi 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 bura mein. I don't know. Anything I said, the reality, this is what happened. So what is happening to our relationships at home? Are we applying Islam as a way of life in our relationships? Or are we applying this method? Now, why our marriages are breaking down? Why our relationships are breaking down? What's happening? There is no muhabba, there is no pyar, there is nothing. Whole confusion. Why? That's why everything is because the clarity nahi hai basics mein, then we have the confusion. That's why what I saw for myself, that's why this work came into existence, is to find out, is not addressing the issues on the external. How many issues can we address on the external? It's not solving the issues. But who Allah is asking, Allah is going to say who is important. Who is addressing the issue? Who is dealing with that? Like who could change the karenge? Fundamental clarity nahi aayega, so everything is chaos outside. So we have to go to the base foundation, clear this one, this is clear. That's what I said, the foundation is correct. You're saying the roots are clear, the fruits within. So the base, yeah, base pe kaam karke, clarity now. The external, you don't have to tell this.
Everything
some of the fundamental things you have to have. Anyway, thank you very much for giving this opportunity.
Alhamdulillah. This program has been a very profound program and made a lot of difference in my life. I completed this program in 2004, and after that, the entire family, you know, and my extended family were a part of this program. And this program has immensely moved my life, and my life has been never the same after I've done this program. One important aspect I would like to share with you, how I have applied this program to understand Deen in a very profound way. This concept that we actually talked about, being a human and the being. There are a lot of hadith that we study on a very daily basis. One famous hadith is about Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam going to Taif and presenting Islam, right? And then I don't want to go into detail, but we know the sequence. What happened, that people started throwing stones and, you know, taunting him, etc., etc. And in one narration I heard, which actually made me very emotional, is that there was one person who came with a chain. It had a hook at the end. And when he hit Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it went on his skull and the hook went inside. And this led to profound bleeding that happened, which we know that the blood went in his shoes, and when the shoes were removed, the skin came out, right? And we know what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also responded, saying that, "Oh Allah, don't punish them because they don't know me." And he also created a future, saying that somebody from their clan will understand and they'll be Muslims. So this is a very profound story or a hadith or a fact that we know. But then how to apply it? Anything altered here in the physical realm was nothing to do with what he had to do. And he was stuck to the core purpose for why he was created and what was his mission. This is how I began understanding Deen and the different ahadiths, and really connected to this concept, which was very profound for me. And this is life-altering. And now, if I have to do anything to control my emotions, it's so easy. I always see where I am and where I'm connected to. This is very important. See, now we attend a lot of workshops, and this is one of the most profound workshops I have experienced. Life-altering transformational workshop. This is a 3-day workshop, and you know, I have recommended everybody to be a part of this program, because if we get this part of what it is, our life is never the same. Now, what actually happens is people gain a lot of knowledge. Okay? But then, there's a difference between being knowledgeable and to be educated. Okay? You can say a book, na? Pick up any book. Do you say the book is educated? We say a book has a lot of knowledge, correct? But you never say the book is knowledge in action is education. So what we have gained today is a lot of profound knowledge, and how to apply that into various aspects of life is something that we have to look at. Okay. And that is going to be very transformational for our life. And it's going to make a difference to all those people that actually depend and connect with us. We alter our inside and the external alters. That is the pickup from here that we got. And we actually look at intellect which is very important. Rasulullah said, fear the intellect of a mu'min. Fear the intellect of a mu'min, because he sees with the vision of Allah. اتَّخُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ وَيَنْزُرُوا بِنُورِ اللَّهِ. Because he is not looking at what he is today, what is happening right now. He is looking at the core purpose. Why I have been created and what's my mission? What is my direction where I have to go? So whatever happens in the physical realm, nothing should alter us. This is who we are. And this is what is expectation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from all of us. So this is what I wanted to share with you, because this workshop, what we have today experienced over these three sessions, three Sundays, it just a taster, it's a teaser. But 9 to 6 for 3 days, where you will have an opportunity to experience the entire detailing of what it really means, what are the distinctions of life, how to follow the distinctions, and also a profound opportunity for all of you to share your challenges and take coaching. Okay? We all have a family doctor. Don't you think so? We all have a family doctor. But then we have a doctor that actually alters the physical realm, the physical part of us, the body part of it. Right? But who is here? No one. We don't have a family alim or a coach, you know, actually altering our spiritual part of our being, which is very fundamental, because everything starts from here and reveals here. Every idea starts where? In the spiritual world, but manifest into the physical. Okay? So we need to find somebody who can alter this. And for me, the best coach is here, Dr. Sadat. Okay, he has been that guide, the coach for me all my life. Okay, and you know, I have my gratitude for you, sir, for what you've done for my life. Very profound personality that I've experienced in him. That it doesn't matter. You see that his energy level didn't go down looking at this crowd, because this is nothing for him. What he says is, even if there is one person, I will do this program for him. Even if there is one person, I will do this program. If he transforms, meri akhirat ban jati, uski bhi akhirat ban jati. This is his approach. Okay. Very few people that you will find on this planet who will do that. Okay. I always say that, you know, he says what he does and what impact that he has created wherever he has gone, local, international. Dil se jo baat nikalti hai, asar rakhti hai. Dil se jo baat nikalti hai, asar rakhti hai. Par nahi, taakhat-e parwaaz magar rakhti hai. How many people he has transformed, we don't know. But he will know it when he faces Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our prayers are with you for what you are doing for the community, sir. Thank you very much. And thank you for all of you who have been here. Jazakumullahu khair. That you are chosen people from so many people who knew that there is a program here. And you chose to come here to seek transformation for your life. And I pray that all your intentions that you have, that have been expressed or deep inside your heart, may Allah fulfill it. Jazakallah.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Almost 10-15 years back, I attended Sa'adullah Sahab's first workshop. And I'm very thankful to my wife. She's been telling me to go.
No? Okay.
And I was telling, oh, what is that? I know about it and things like that. But she persistently told that you should attend the program. And then one fine day, I got up in the morning. It was announced after 1 month. So very hesitantly, I went. And it was in Al-Amin College, maybe about 15 years back, I think. So I attended the function. Within half an hour, I was totally engrossed as to what he was telling. And it was to my frequency. I all the time used to think that it's just not namaz and roza that makes us really something good. But it is the humanity, the human consideration of others, which should be the factor. And he was hitting it straight to the point. One by one, the topics he took, and he started telling it, I said, this is it. Finally, I have met a person who's going to really change me, and I'm going to get all my answers. The 3 days, I don't know how it went. If it was for 1 week also, I wouldn't have missed a single minute. It's just fantastic. And I think, as of I know, we don't have any such person who's going to give us this kind of knowledge. You have a lot of other people telling you about Islam and Deen and so many things, but you're losing on the basics. Once you know the basics, then everything else you understand. Well, giving a little example in my life, how I have changed. A lot of incidents has happened. A recent one, because unless we apply this in our life, we will not realize how useful this is. I have also given him many earlier also, but this is a recent, sir. Traveling to my office. Normally, this is in the travel, a lot of things happen where you are tested. So there was another big car came. I was taking a turn. It hit. Okay, I'm not going to details who was right, who was wrong. I used his logic. I said, what happened? I've hit the car, and that fellow was getting down from the car. There was a traffic was piling up. I told him, sit in the car. We just drive down. We'll meet there. So he understood, educated man. We drove down to a certain distance. Both of us stood. And as he said, I just hit the car. That's it. Let's see what happens. So I got down from the car. I was also in a hurry. And I believe he started shouting and things like that. I said, cool. Don't get shouted. Let's sort it out. After all, it's a small thing. It can be sorted out. And I told him, he said he has to go out of station. I took out my visiting card. I gave it to him. I said, you go visit your station, wherever you want to go, come back. I'm available all the time. You get in touch with me, we'll try to sort it out. That itself, you know, he started seeing stars. What is this fellow? He has not told any single thing. And he's trying to be very good to me. And then I started asking him, what are you doing? I just changed the topic. I've been like a friend to him. So immediately his reaction was totally different. Okay, sir, no problem. All right. He took the card and I said, you carry on. I'm available anytime. This is my personal number, this is my office number, anytime. So after 1 month, there was no call. I thought this fellow has maybe forgotten. No, he called me up. He called me and said, after 1 or 2 months, he called me up. He had repaired his car. He has spent 24,000 rupees. He was hesitant to call me. Although I was liable to pay him. So then one fine day, he said, because the amount was quite a lot, and he was a young guy. So he called me and said, sir, can we meet? I had forgotten. I said, I'm so and so. Oh, yeah, sure, we'll meet. So we met in a place, and then I asked him, what happened? Why you didn't call me? I didn't have his number, unfortunately. He didn't give me his number. I gave him my number. I said, why you didn't call me? And he was telling me, sir, you were so good at that day, I was feeling ashamed to call you. Ashamed to call you and ask you that you have to give me some money and all that. Anyway, I got most of it, around 18,000-19,000 rupees has been cleared by insurance. It's only 4,000-6,000 rupees, it's okay. I said, no, that is definitely my part of it. I told him, whatever insurance takes, you take care of it, our balance I'll pay. So anyway, whatever the little amount I had to pay, I paid. And afterwards, you know what he said? This calls for a dinner. We went for dinner, he spent much more than that, and today we are very good friends. Not to mention, he's a non-Muslim. So, this shows, if you apply in real life, it's going to make it, one, whatever he feels about me is also something great. If he takes me, a Muslim was so good. That was a very nice thing. And for me, it was so peaceful. What accident could have been a trauma for me, became a friendship and it gave me happiness. What was supposed to be a bad event in life turned out to be a happy event for me. Anyway, with this small thing and the time running out, I'd like to thank Sadat Sahab for his long life, and may God bless him. And let each every one of us take advantage of this. Don't take it easy. This is the way of life. This is understanding of life. Rest what you do is your personal matter. What he says, I rightly accept. Your namaz, your roza, your hajj, your zakat, it's your personal matter. Nobody else gets benefited out of it. What gets benefited is your behavior with the next person. Please do not look at the second person as a X, Y, Z, Hindu, this, that, and all that. He is a human being. Please. Thank you, sir.